No, funnel guy. I think I'm going to go do some cleanup first. I'm going to go here. Now that I have, finally, I have the air dash, which is great. It's a great innovation. It's pretty hard to imagine Mega Man X without it now, especially with how complicated it gets after, you know, after part one, at least. It gets even more insane with X3. Fucked it up. Come on, man. There we go. So, there we go. There's your Buster upgrade. Which is also kind of a weird thing. You start this game, you have none of the upgrades you had from the last game. Your life is back down to its original pathetic state. However, you do have the dash, which is weird. But you lost everything else. I don't know why that is. Who knows? Maybe he just voluntarily took all the shit out of his body, but he's still got to fight Mavericks. It's not like his job is done. So I don't know what's going on. Which is why this game isn't quite as effective in theming as the other game. Because the first game, like, is more memorable, it's more iconic. For the fact that, you know, like, the theme was new at that point. Where you started out weak, and you had all these guys kicking your ass, and you were becoming stronger by playing the game. But in this game, I mean, we've already done that before, and now it's the same shit. I'm becoming stronger by playing the game. But, you know, there's a continuity here where I was strong, and now I'm weak again, and no explanation for it whatsoever. It's sort of like that thing where if you're playing a superhero game and you can't just start them out with all their superpowers because the game will have no challenge because you're a fucking superhero. So you gotta figure out some kind of weird mechanic to take away all your powers. Or even worse. This jump is fucking ridiculous. It's even worse than that jump in Mega Man X1 for the optional arm upgrade. In Flame Mammoth stage. That one you could fuck up though and have to redo the whole stage though. So, not as bad. You can't run out of energy though eventually and just have to come back and do it again, I guess. So that sucks. So now, real quick, I'm gonna go do this stage. Which, by the way, normally when I play this game, I do the stage first. Because this is one of the easiest stages in the game. And all the items, like, you can find all the hidden items in one trip. You don't have to backtrack. And the boss is really easy. So, all around, a great place for beginners. If you've never played this game before, which chances are most of you haven't, this game is very unpopular. And I think, I would imagine just that there was so few copies of the game, which is why it's so fucking expensive. Mega Man X3 is the same way. I think that one might even be worse. I'm not even sure. But yeah. This is a great stage for beginners. Because it's the easiest one. The only reason I'm doing it now is because of the shit I was talking to you about earlier. I want to wrap shit up faster. Which consequently may not even help. But whatever. So most of this is just an onslaught of these same ass enemies that are just dropping shit. And the weather keeps changing, which is kind of cool. All these lighting effects that keep switching around for no reason. So now we're getting up on the end. Which I don't know if the stages in this game are any longer than they are in Mega Man X1. I think they seem about the same to me, but I could be wrong. Not much of a benefit from Mega Man X1. It didn't have a whole lot of improvements. There was the air dash. That's cool. And, I think they're the same amount of stages. The stages are about the same. They did change the ending stages to make it longer, which is cool. Because they have a boss rush in this game. If you remember, Mega Man X1 was a lot like the original Mega Man. It was almost like a complete upgrade remake of Mega Man 1. Just a million times better. And this one feels more like the other Mega Mans that came after. They kind of, you know, created other other traditions that were opposed to the original traditions. Like in Mega Man 1, you didn't have a boss rush. You just had the ending stages that had all the bosses placed in them. In this game, you do have a boss rush. So that's kind of cool. That's one of the few things. You kill him with the cutters, he cuts himself in half. Otherwise, that animation doesn't happen. Look totally boss with all my upgrades now. So now, I have to have a little intervention where Dr. Kane says, "You totally suck balls. I don't know what you were trying to do. If you were trying to collect Zero's parts and you were trying to resurrect him yourself and you actually contribute to mankind and the world and justice, well, all your efforts were in vain because they fucking took... They took all of Zero's parts, and they broke in and stole his control chip. So basically, I'm saying we're fucked. However, we did figure out where their base is. It's at the Magnetic North. So, go to the North Pole and kick their ass. Or else I'll box you, and that'll be the end of you. So now I'm revisiting this stage. And I'm going to show you where the hidden items are. Along with something else that you probably didn't even know existed. So, you need the bubbles to get up here. Because they make you float. So, you can jump much higher in the water. Which is kind of weird. But, yeah, whatever. I guess it works. Now I have to do it again, because up here is an E-Tank. Only now I have to fucking do this thing that I never could understand, where apparently Mega Man X can jump on the top of water, but yeah, it's kind of weird. Does it work perfectly? You have to kind of just spam it right when you hit the water top. So now I haven't left the stage yet. You may be wondering, what the fuck are you doing? You're just shooting rocks everywhere. What purpose can you possibly be having now? Well, check this out. There's a couple places like this in the game. There's just little hidden spots that you go in. You use this charge power, the charge up soak shot, and you can instantly refill all of your shit, which is awesome. I don't think they put this shit in any of the other Mega Man games, but I wish they did. That shit's fucking awesome. It's incredible. So now we're going on to these... I guess you'd call them the X-Hunter stages. Try to blitz them as fast as possible. They're pretty straightforward, pretty easy. They're actually a lot shorter than they seem. They're much less intimidating than they appear. This is really the most intimidating part. When you're fighting these guys that are pulling the walls together. The game gets even easier if you actually liberally use all of your power-up weapons, all these abilities you've gotten. Because I mean, most of them are kind of weird. You know, they're not as cool as the Mega Man X 1 ones. I'll give you that. They're definitely not as cool as the Mega Man X 3 weapons. But most of them are pretty fucking powerful. And you don't have to be afraid to use them, because this isn't Mega Man. In Mega Man, in between all the stages, you didn't recharge any of your energy, so you had to conserve that shit. You had to be real fucking careful, because you needed them on all the bosses later. But in this game, not so much. So, use whatever the fuck you want as much as you want, because the only item you're going to need, I mean for sure, is the weapon that... You know what? Fuck you. I hit you like 20 times with a fucking chain, and you wouldn't die, so fuck you. This is a God of War, motherfucker. This is Mega Man. So the only weapon you really need of all these stages is the one weapon that destroys the boss of the stage. So this stage is the bubbles. The most intimidating fucking asshole in this entire game, who does a fuck ton of damage. There's seriously no I mean, I've jumped on infinite instant death spikes that were less damaging than this guy's fucking mace. And I'm using fucking armor upgrade. If I wasn't using the armor upgrade, I would already be dead. I would have to use two E-tanks to survive. And the worst part is his ability, like, his attacking is completely random. Sometimes he uses that fucking in-your-face trajectory that pisses you off. Sometimes it gets stuck up in the corner. Those blocks that he fucking summoned out of oblivion, he can change the position of those. He can jump around and shoot sparklers at you, which is not very effective. But basically, you just have to get lucky. There's no real trick to it. Just shoot him with bubbles and hope you get lucky. Because this shit is really hard to dodge, because it's fucking constant, it's huge, and does a hell of a lot of damage. Way more than anybody else is going to be doing. Unless you don't know how to fight the final boss properly. He could do a lot of damage, too. So now, a lot of this stage is going to be underwater. Killed one X-Hunter. Now there's two more to go. Now, the thing is, you wouldn't know this because I didn't fight the guys earlier, but when you fight the X-Hunters, they're actually a bit different. The X-Hunter that you fought, Violin is pretty much exactly the same as he was in the normal stages. If you took the optional route to kill the X-Hunter, you don't really kill them, you just fight them until they say, alright, I've had enough. You win, I'm gonna retreat like a little bitch. Violin fights exactly the same, except, I don't think he had the sparkler attack, and he couldn't summon blocks out of nowhere to jump on, but that was it. Now I gotta wait for an elevator, because I don't like jumping into death. And this takes like 20 minutes. There we go. Now you're supposed to jump on the side and avoid the fire, but fuck it. I don't want to deal with the consequences of falling off and having to go up here again. So this part will infuriate you if you didn't know how to fucking traverse this shit. This becomes a trope that you need to start using. Because you're gonna see enemies near instant death spike platforms, and you won't be able to traverse them without crystallizing the enemies. Pluto, instant death. No problem. I'm good, bro. So, I'm gonna be fighting Surges now. And Surges is way different than he was when you fought him in the regular stages. Because in regular stages, he was just at eye level on a little floating platform, and he would jump around shooting sparks at you, or he would drop landmines. So he's kind of difficult to dodge, but that was pretty much it. He wasn't that all that intimidating. And he also had an invincibility cloak, which is kind of stupid. But this thing is a fucking monstrosity. You kill it real fast with the fucking magnets, and then you have to hit him in the face with the little cutters. It's almost like two weaknesses that you have to worry about. Now the problem here is that he fights like a little bitch. He refuses to at any time be eye level with you unless he's frozen in place from shooting a blast at you. So you have to time this shit just right, like 100 times, and hope you don't die first, because I have had a tendency where occasionally I will land on one of these two platforms and it would just not register, and I'll just literally fall through the middle of the platform to my death. So I like to stay on the up ground because, you know, it's easy. You can actually hit him by jumping down and shooting at him. But if you go on the bottom level, then he'll just hang around the top, and you can't reach him, because you can't jump up and hit him. So, that's why I stay up here most of the time. It's easier to find rhythm to hit him right in the middle. Probably even easier if the fucking the blades didn't have, like, that long-ass delay where it took so long to reach over and hit the guy, which kind of contributes to him being able to fight like a bitch. Like, that little hitbox is a lot smaller than it looks, too, because, like, that little flap in front of his ship, the little gray spot, that blocks attacks, so you have to hit him basically right in the forehead. Sucks. It's not hard, he just fights like a bitch, and I hate it. So, Now we're coming to the third stage. We're going to fight Ajax, which I don't know what the fuck happened to him. He bears no resemblance to his previous form. Because when you first fight him, he's sort of like fighting Sigma from Mega Man X1. He just has a sword, and he's a badass, and charges at you with the sword and shoots big fucking wall barriers at you that you have to dodge. That's pretty much it. He just fights like a warrior, you know? Sort of like Zero. And at the end of this stage, he's just... He's not even like... You know, Surgis was just controlling some big machine because he's like an engineer kind of guy. But he's not controlling anything. Agile is not controlling anything in this stage. He's just fucking been transformed into a giant, horrible thing. It's still kind of cool, but it's really weird. It doesn't make any sense. And then you saw the fucking enemies respawn before it even died. Something I hate about fucking Mega Man games, where enemies just respawn before they even fucking disappear. Because they could still be on the screen and still... It always aggravates me. But it's less annoying in these games than it is in the classic Mega Man games, because, you know, the classic Mega Man games, like, it was all about little screens. Like, you go through one screen, and then you'd traverse to the next area, so the enemy placement was more aggravating. Usually they were harder to kill. And so he's like, oh, I finally killed that guy, and you walk back, and he's respawned for no apparent reason. So here's Agile. Look at him. What the fuck is going on with him? He doesn't look anything like he did before. And he doesn't even look like he's piloted a thing. He looks like he's been transformed. Some horrible mechanical experiment. So he's really got the two attacks. He can spawn those things, which don't kill you instantly. They just do damage. So you have two problems. You have those giant things, those giant exploding maces he shoots at you. And not falling in the middle where there's a hole, because that will kill you. But you don't even have to jump up and hit them and risk getting hit. You can just shoot them with the magnets, which do a fuck ton of damage. Because you can aim the magnets whatever direction you want. Yeah.